In this video, we will cover the basic features and functions of Dynamo for Civil 3D. Now, Dynamo is not a complex programming language just for programmers. It is actually intended for engineers, architects, and designers who want to save time, improve design efficiencies, and enhance their workflows. Dynamo is a programming platform with a visual interface, and this allows users to construct logical routines that automate workflows and help to save time. And please note, there are a number of additional learning resources for Dynamo, and those are shown here. The workspace contains standard menus and toolbars, and Dynamo contains an extensive library of nodes and commands that are organized by category. Nodes are classified by three behaviors. The green plus represents nodes that create an element. The red lightning bolt represents an action method, and the blue question mark represents an input or property query. When the user expands the node tree, they can hover over a node and a description will appear, as well as the inputs and outputs for that node. Users can also search nodes by name in the search field. Any node with the inputted information is going to appear on that list. And the execution bar allows users to select either automatic or manual runs. Now, nodes are placed in the work area, and the user can actually toggle between the script and the output view to see their results. And we'll work through a very simple example here to illustrate some of these points. We'll specify a point, and our point coordinates are going to be 0, and we'll copy that number and paste it there. And we'll specify our x and y as 0 and 0. We'll select another point, but for this point, we will select number sliders so that we can adjust these points and see how that changes on our screen. And so we'll connect those as the x and as the y value as well. And as we adjust these, we can see on our output that point has moved. If we set that to manual and then we adjust it, it won't move until we tell it to run. So let's set some values here, 5 and 7. And we actually want to create a circle, but we'll do this by a radius. And so we'll select a distance to node to provide our radius input. And next we'll go under geometry, curves, and circle, and we'll select that by radius so that we can create a circle from those two points. And when we hit run, those have adjusted and it creates that circle for us. We can adjust that slider, run it again on either side, and our output provides the circle that we have created. Now, the anatomy of a node is such that as we hover over the different inputs, we can see what values are required as well as what output is expected. And after we run, we can actually hover over the auto area and see the actual values that this node is returning. We can see our x and y values correspond to our slider and our z value is set to 0. Next, we'll get into using code blocks. If we want to create a note, a single line note in a code block, we do that with a double forward slash. If we want a multi-line note, we'll do that with a forward slash and an asterisk. And here we're just creating a note saying that we're going to specify a couple of variables after this note. To close the note, you'll do that with an asterisk and a forward slash as well. Here we want to just specify one variable and we'll set the value to 1. We'll set variable number 2 or B at 2.35. And if we want to set up a string, we need to do that with quotes. And here we'll just set up ETW as edge of travel way as one of our strings. And if we want to create an equation or a formula, we can specify that in here as well. And so this provides four different outputs that we can actually use in a script. Dynamo will also notify us anytime we have an error in our scripting. In this case, we have a point by coordinate, but we're going to input a string value. When we hit run, our node turns yellow, indicating that we have some sort of an input error. Our node will turn red anytime we have a syntax error. In this case, we need a 0 before any decimal value. And once we provide the correct values and then rerun the script, we will see that point appear in the view area. Now, a very useful tool in Dynamo is to freeze a node. This is great for troubleshooting a script because we can isolate certain areas of our script. Everything up to that node will run, but that node doesn't run until we unfreeze it. Once we unfreeze it, we can see that point reappear with our corrected values. As our script progresses, we can group nodes together and indicate the function of the group. We can also change the color of the group by right-clicking on the area. Node connectors indicate the workflow direction, so this generally moves from left to right. And for more advanced users, Dynamo supports Python nodes, and those can be customized to the user's specific requirements. There are several classifications of inputs, and they include Booleans or true-false, inputs as functions or values, numbers, and those can come from a slider or can be user-specified values, or a string or a text. The output will display the value that we connect to it. If we change the execution to manual, those results don't display until we rerun the command. There are several functions for AutoCAD and for Civil 3D. First, we'll specify the document that we're working in, and there are a variety of functions with inputs that are described in the notes. For instance, we can import a block, and that looks for text values, Boolean values, and the document we're working in. Or we can create lines and circles and other elements. Again, all of those have values that we'll input. In Civil 3D, we can identify corridors that we've worked on, or baselines, feature lines, or even point codes that are contained within our corridor. With these elements, we can label points or slopes, we can insert objects along the corridor, or we can extract properties from the corridor. Dynamo is a powerful tool with a lot of capabilities, and we encourage you to jump in and get started.